this guy put out a statement and he said, you're going to come for our president? Here's the type of statement that, boy, it'd be awfully fucking quiet. If you don't understand that the GOP is not on our side, take a look at the fucking non-action and the non-rhetoric coming from the GOP. They just told everybody that they want to arrest our president on Tuesday. And all these cocksuckers from the GOP establishment, awfully quiet. They quiet as fuck. Here's the response that the I know you guys ain't sending money to the GOP, but if you got friends or you got family that's sending money to the GOP, you need to harangue them. You need to say, are you fucking insane? Why do you keep sending money to the GOP? When they send you a letter begging for money, you need to wipe that letter with your ass and send that the fuck, send a bill. You say, no, fuck you. You owe me my money back. I've been sending you thousands of dollars over the last 20 years. You give me my motherfucking money back, you criminals. Awfully fucking quiet. No, this is the type of response. This is how you respond when somebody fucks with you. Quote, holy shit, I wish I could do a Russian accent. Quote, any nation that is stupid enough to attempt to arrest a Russian president will see its citizens burned in nuclear apocalypse. An attack on the head of state is an attack on the Russian state's right to exist. Dmitry Medvedev. I'm pregnant. I'm fucking pregnant. Hold on a second. I'm gonna wash that the fuck down. That is a statement so sexy, delicious that you gotta wash that down with some field of grains. Oh, big chug. I'm gonna snort some of this. Hold on. That was fucking crazy as that. Holy shit. Any nation that is stupid enough to attempt to arrest a Russian president will see its citizens burned in a nuclear apocalypse. Holy fuck. Damn. That's an insanely odd. Can I fit all of that on a shirt? Can I? Let me see. How do I do this? You see, I could probably fit some of that on a shirt. Damn. So yeah, the guy is just driving around. He's just driving around. I don't know anything about Russia. I don't want to live in Russia. But that's the type of energy that you need when you're running an organization. You might be running a country. You might be running a business. But when you win the right, you win the right. And when somebody comes fucking with people of your establishment, of your organization, then you unleash a verbal barrage in their direction. And in this case, he's going to back it up with fucking nukes. Yeah. Fuck the International Criminal Court. Fuck them. Fuck NPR. And fuck you idiots on the left-hand side. All of this that's happening right now is an attempt to overshadow, to hide, to obfuscate the fact that the world order is rapidly changing. And the biggest threat to what these criminals want to institute is a bunch of geeked up savages who are America first. If you're America first, right? There's plenty of people out there. And there's some people, you see it in the crowd. Some people don't like Trump, but they're still America first. That's the overall big problem. People understand, I don't give a shit about Ukraine. I don't give a shit about Ukraine. Ethiopia is the new grift, apparently. We send a lot of money to Ethiopia now. It's like, holy shit, can we launder money? All these fucking countries, our country's under attack. It's under assault. Your way of life, your quality of life, your purchasing power, your children's inheritance, everything's being stolen from us. It's being stolen from us. And they don't want the group of people recognizing that to have any control, any power, any influence. So they got to shut everything down. And if they got to set the fucking world on fire in order to do it, they'll do it. If they got to arrest Donald Trump in order to do it, they'll do it. And that's what you're saying.